So you may be wondering, how in the world do the people who have the most wins and the highest rank in the leaderboard have such a high level? Well, it's simple. They follow one golden rule. They do a specific strategy. So this specific strategy, when put right, can be super, super OP. And honestly, it's just, and honestly, it isn't even that expensive. All you need is DJ, shotgun, cryo blaster, and juggernaut. And that's literally all you need. Next, you have to go to Deserted Island. I don't know why that switched to Swath, but the Deserted Island is the map that you need. Mainly because of the fact that it gives the most possible money. And it's just super helpful. It also gives you the most amount of XP in terms of its bonus. So yeah. All right, so upon joining, you need to just select easy mode, because yes, this is an easy mode strat, and I'm gonna be sharing it to you guys, because, well, I believe it's the fastest easy mode strat out there, and it's one of the easiest. All right, so you need to place two of these shotgunners like so, and set this one to last. It's fine if you get a leak at first, but you want to upgrade both of them to bottom half one time. Alright, afterwards you want to upgrade them both to top path, and we may have one more leak here, but that's fine. And that's going to be the last leak that you're going to have. Now feel free to skip every wave, because now we're going to be upgrading this one to top path one time. And then we go back to the second shotgun. Now you really just go back and forth here, and for the one that's targeting first, get the bigger buckshot upgrade. Now get this one to the same upgrade, and you should be set for a little bit. Now all you have to do is save up for the militant upgrade on this shotgun right here. So you can skip waves if you have to. Now that you got the militant upgrade, save up for advanced goggles so we get that hidden detection before the stealths come in, so we don't take an aggressive amount of damage. So we got that. Now it's just saving for juggernaut. Feel free to skip every wave until then. Now, in my opinion, after doing this strat a whole bunch of times, it is super easy, and it is a 100% success rate if you do everything correctly. And some minor mistakes are okay, but mainly around the parts where the abominations come in, those are where you have to kind of pay attention. Other than that, you are pretty much like free to go. And this works on literally every single map that contains just an area big enough to get all these towers in. So yeah, you can do this with every map unless there's like a blockade or something. So yeah, now that we got our juggernaut placed right here, we need to get power gloves and joint suppressors, and then afterwards we get bottom upgrades until the dual guns. After you get the dual guns upgrade, sell the shotgunner that's focusing on last, and then save up for yet again another juggernaut and place it right next to the juggernaut right here. Get it to the same level and we should be ready for the next step. Now, this isn't really about speed, but more on just accuracy in general and efficiency, and you can get a pretty quick runtime. I've gotten 4 minutes with the speed boost right here, and it is pretty darn good. So I'd say it is a very quick and easy strat that almost everyone can use. And now that you got your second juggernaut, feel free to sell your last shotgunner, and now place yet again another juggernaut right over here. Get it to the same level as always, and let's just skip this wave. All right, so now that we got that juggernaut down, we can now place the DJ. Now we are going to place the DJ right next to this tree so it covers these two guys right here. We're also gonna get this max level on the bottom path. All right, so this wave is pretty annoying, so just skip it no matter what, because it's just gonna waste a lot of time. So yeah, now that we got max level DJ, we can now upgrade all of our juggernauts to cybernetic core. And this upgrade will basically ensure that we stay alive during those revived abomination rushes. And yeah, Once you got all of those juggernauts to cybernetic core, you want to place 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 cryo blasters and target them all to strongest and max them out on the bottom path, like so. And you want to do this to all of them. And yep, you guessed it, we are going to freeze the final boss. So this ensures our victory. And in the meantime, they're gonna freeze the abominations, which will also greatly help with crowd control. And even we can skip right now because, well, it's not really that big of a problem. There you go. And just feel free to place whatever you want, because it's just a win. It's just a win, so yeah. And as you can see, the plague doctor is frozen, and we win. Now, every win on this grants you 337 gold and 3,319 XP. And we did this in 5 minutes and 5.5 seconds. So yeah, that was pretty fast. Now, this is literally the fastest way of grinding up XP and money doing solo runs. And that's basically how I got to where I am right now. However, for you tech nerds, macroing is also a valid option if you know how to create your macro, because currently there are no macros for the public. And yeah, honestly, work smarter, not harder. But if you can't macro, it's fine. You can just use the strat over and over again, and you should be able to get quite a lot of cash flow and XP, but it's better than nothing. So yeah. Anyways, if you enjoy this kind of content, be sure to subscribe, like, and of course, comment down below on which one you see next. I'll pin a random comment, because why not? And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next one. Goodbye.